Hey, it's almost September 2024, and of course that means there's another monthly update for Home Assistant. This time it's version 2024.9, where sections have been further developed, you can track untracked energy, and improvements have been made to LLM agents once again. Let's quickly check out what's new. Yes, here we are again, this time with the September update of Home Assistant version 2024.9. Thanks to the new options in this release, my dashboard is looking better and better and works perfectly on my dashboard, tablet and phone. Version 2024.9 will be released on the first Wednesday of September. This video is based on the beta release, so there may still be some minor changes made before that Wednesday. First of all, you can now stretch a section across multiple columns. This way you can create a header, for example, that only shows messages if they are relevant. In my case, I use it to display whether there's a mouse in my mousetrap or if the garbage needs to be put out on the street. Also, check out my video on how to automate your mousetrap. But it can also be useful to create one section with a single column and another section with two columns to display a larger version of your history, map or camera. You can now specify per card whether it should be displayed across the entire width of the section, so you have a lot of flexibility. Take a look at this example. Here I created a view that is three columns wide. I started by creating a section that spans the full width. In it I placed a mushroom title card with the title of this view. In my case it's My Home. I set this card to occupy the full width of the section. Then I created a second row. First I made a section that is one column wide. Inside I created a menu that links to all the rooms in my house. For each menu card I set it to take up the entire width of the section. Next to it I created a section that is two columns wide. Within this section I placed a picture entity card that shows my doorbell camera. I also set this camera to be a full width card, so my camera is nicely displayed across two columns. At the bottom I created a section that is three columns wide. Inside it I added some more menu buttons, which are neatly displayed next to each other. You can probably imagine how flexible you can now set up your dashboard. It's entirely up to you how your dashboard will look. As I mentioned in an earlier video, I will make a complete dashboard video once the sections are fully developed by the Home Assistant team. But that may take a while with all the changes that we see coming through every month. In the energy dashboard, you could recently start tracking the energy usage of individual devices. However, your home often consumes more energy than what you monitor per device. In the individual devices detail usage graph, you can now also see the untracked consumption. This can help you identify which devices you might want to install an individual energy tracker for, such as a smart plug or something similar. Home Assistant already supports two cloud-based conversation agents, namely OpenAI and Google AI. Additionally, the local conversation agent Olama has been supported since version 2024.8 of Home Assistant. Starting with version 2024.9, the cloud-based conversation agent Anthropic is also supported, giving you even more options to experiment with AI in Home Assistant. To be honest, I don't use voice commands much in Home Assistant. My home is mostly automated with smart automations that work independently. I'm actually curious to know who uses the voice features in Home Assistant on a daily basis, especially the AI options. I think there won't be many people who do. Let me know in the comments if you use AI and voice in Home Assistant. I'm very curious. As with every new version of Home Assistant, this version also includes some new integrations and a few changes to existing integrations. You can find the full list here. One of the things that caught my eye is that you can now create a number template helper via the UI. Nice. Besides the things I've already shown you, there are a few other things worth mentioning. You can find them in this list. The link is in the description of this video. And of course, there are also the backward incompatible changes. Before you update Home Assistant, it is always a good idea to carefully review this list to make sure nothing will break when you perform the update. For example, take note of the proximity entity that has been removed in this version. I previously made a video explaining how to use proximity to detect if someone is approaching your house so you can turn on the heating in advance. Check it out! So, these were the new features and changes in Home Assistant 2024.9. Thanks for watching. If my videos help you, you can support me via Patreon, Ko-fi, or by becoming a paid member of my channel. You can find the links in the description of the video. These people have already supported me, and without them, this channel would not have existed for so long. Thank you for all the trust. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I'll see you soon in my next video. Bye bye. This release. This video is based on the beta. Then what you monitor. One of the things that you Oh, why am I doing this, man? Really? Okay.